In Manhattan, we follow Isaac Davis, who is a divorced writer of TV shows. His ex-wife left him for a woman and is writing a book about their marriage. Isaac himself is dating a 17-year-old high school student, Tracy, who is in love with him. But the feeling isn't mutual, as he views her as too immature and young to have a serious relationship with. He, early on in the film, meets Mary, who he soon becomes infatuated with, and this leads to him becoming involved with her, which causes his relationship with Tracy to end. The entire film revolves around those three relationships and a couple of other plot points. His relationship with Mary, however, doesn't work out, and at the end of the film, after contemplating what makes life worth living, he realizes, or himself thinks, that Tracy is the one he truly loves. Isaac then attempts to stop Tracy from leaving America. Tracy, however, has already made up her mind and is set to leave to England. But she ensures him that they can continue their relationship when she returns. However, Isaac isn't too sure. The film ends with this scene, but it's the last moments of this scene that really speak volumes to both Isaac's and Tracy's character arc and the film's ending.
I've got to make a plan.
You don't have to go.
Why couldn't you have brought this up last week? 6 months isn't so long. Everybody gets corrupted. Look, you have to have a little faith in people.
While this ending seems to indicate that he is in fact going to wait for her to return to America and continue their relationship, I believe this isn't the case. To me, the smile Isaac gives at the end is him realizing that, despite spending the entire film talking about how naive and immature he thinks Tracy is, she is in fact more mature than him and any other character we see in the film, which, in my opinion, makes the film's ending much more profound and meaningful. Do you agree with my analysis of Manhattan's ending? Comment down below if you do or don't.